Hey guys, Jake here, coming at you with another math lesson today. We're going to continue on the theme of deciding between the product rule versus chain rule and how to actually apply these rules to find derivatives of functions for today and for the rest of the week. If you didn't see the part one of this series, I'll link it here so you can go check that out. But that video was just about deciding whether you want to use the product rule or the chain rule. Today I'm going to actually get into a bit of how to actually apply these. So we're going to start with this example here, which I talked about at the end of that last video, which is to find the derivative of 4 sine squared x plus 3 sine x minus 4. So like I discussed at the very end of that last video, and just like was discussed in the book, The Calculus Lifesaver by Adrian Banner, you can see that book here. I have the ebook copy. You can find this book on Amazon. I'll link the in the description so you can check that out. You can get it in ebook or paperback form for less than $20. So it's a great resource to help explain these calculus concepts really in a easy to understand and intuitive way. So definitely check that book out. It's a good read when you're learning calculus for the first time. But as was discussed in that book when discussing the chain rule, the easiest way to apply the chain rule to actually find the derivative of a function like this is to first determine kind of what your inside function would be, or essentially, if you're thinking about writing this as a composite function, what's the function that you're plugging into some other function to get this? So like I said at the end of that last video, that inside function would be sine of x. We can see sine of x appear a couple of times in this function. And what we want to do is just say u equals that sine of x. So now, knowing that u equals sine of x, what we can do is go back through our original function. Wherever we see a sine of x, we're going to replace it with a u. And then we want to think about what that leaves us with and how we can find the derivative of that function. So doing that up here, we'll have y equals 4 times u squared, because sine squared of x is the same as sine of x all squared, right? So if we're saying u equals sine of x all squared is just u squared. So that substitution would take care of that term. Here, then, we'll say sine of x is u, so we have 3u minus 4. So now, you can see we just have 4u squared plus 3u minus 4. So now what we want to do is think about the fact that when we're taking the chain rule, essentially what that's saying is if we're trying to find the derivative of this function y with respect to x, that would be the same as finding the derivative of y with respect to u, times the derivative of that u function with respect to x. So here we have our function u with respect to x. That's just the substitution that we decided to make. And once we plug that u substitution into our original function, that leaves us with y as a function of u, right? Because now our function y has u's instead of x's. So when we're taking our derivative of y with respect to x, first, we want to decide our inner function, say what that is. So u is our function of x now. We're going to need the derivative of that function u with respect to x. So if we know that u is sine of x, the derivative of u with respect to x would just be the derivative of this function. The derivative of sine x is just cosine x. So the derivative of this function u with respect to x is cosine x. Now, the other thing we need to do is figure out the derivative of this function after substituting in u. So now u is our variable. We want to find the derivative of that with respect to u. So taking the derivative of this function y with respect to u, that's just going to require the use of the power rule, right? Bring the 2 down in front would make it 8u, lower the power by 1, plus the derivative of 3u is just going to be 3. And then the derivative of a constant is 0, so that's just going to go away. So now, when we broke this down, this composite function, into these two simpler pieces, we now have the derivative of y with respect to u is all this, and then the derivative of u with respect to x is cosine x, which is just the derivative of this u that we decided. So now, to find that derivative of dy dx, we can just plug in these two pieces that we have into this kind of chain rule formula. So doing that is just going to give us 8u plus 3 times the derivative of u with respect to x. So remember, when you're doing this, you need to make sure to multiply this entire dy du by the entire du dx. So make sure to put parentheses around those two pieces when you're applying this this method. So now the issue is, notice this is in terms of u and this is in terms of x. So now we just want to get it all back in terms of x because we're taking the derivative of y with respect to x. So all we have to do is go back to this u, which is in terms of x, and plug this back in for our u here. So doing that, we'll just replace u with sine of x. And now we have 8 times sine of x plus 3 all being multiplied by cosine x. So now this is all in terms of x like we want it. So like I said, this is exactly how it's discussed in the Calculus Lifesaver by Adrian Banner that I just mentioned, and the link to that is in the description. This is a really kind of intuitive way to think about finding the chain rule. And in that book, he also discusses how you can apply this same thing to 3 or 4 or multiple chain rule being applied to 3 or 4 or 5 or however many functions are all kind of being plugged within each other. Here we only have 2, right? We can break this into a composite function of just 2 functions. But the same pattern applies to multiples. And I'm going to be going over how to do that later in the week as well. So be sure to subscribe to my channel and check back for that video later in the week. But now what I want to talk about is how to apply the product rule. So I discussed this exact function in my last video where I kind of talked about how to choose between the product and chain rule. And we decided that we would use the product rule to find the derivative of this function. So again, I'm going to be showing you, based on that Calculus Lifesaver book, how it was discussed in there to find the product rule. And it really is kind of a similar process. So I want you to think about the similarities and the differences between product rule versus chain rule. Really, the process of applying them is going to look pretty similar. The only difference is, obviously, the product rule is applied when you have a function that is a product of two functions, where the chain rule is used on composite functions. But the process is going to really not be all that different. You just need to make sure to use the right formula. So for the product rule, what we want to do is, looking at our product of these two functions, we want to say that one of them is going to be u and the other one is going to be v. So it doesn't really matter which one you call u and which one you call v, as long as you're breaking it up correctly so that your original function is just u times v. So we see we have ln of x times ln of x plus 2x. If we call one of them u and one of them v, this will end up working out the way it should. So let's just say u is ln of x, and then we'll say v is ln of x plus 2x. So now what we want to do is then find du dx, so basically the derivative of u with respect to x. So the derivative of natural log of x is just 1 over x. And then we need to find dv dx, so the derivative of this v function with respect to x, which derivative of natural log x is 1 over x, and plus the derivative of 2x, which is just 2. So now that we've found, kind of designated the u and the v, and then found our du dx and dv dx, we can basically plug these into the product rule formula, which is essentially just taking the derivative of one of them times the other original plus the derivative of the other one times the first original. So basically all that means is, if we're going to use our original u, so ln of x, we need to multiply that by the derivative of the v. So that will be multiplied by 1 over x plus 2. And then we also need to add the derivative of u, so 1 over x, times the original v without taking the derivative. So essentially, what you could do is just write the combination, however many pieces you have. In this case, we only have 2 pieces, right? So we just have a u and a v. What you could do is essentially think of this formula as u times v plus u times v. So just write, each of your pieces being multiplied together however many times you need to, based on how many there are. So we have 2 functions here, u and v. We write the product of them twice because there's 2 functions. If there were 3, we would do it 3 times. And then we just write d dx in front of a different one as we go through each time. So in this case, we just did the derivative of u with respect to x times our original v. And then over here, we did our original u times the derivative of with respect to x of our function v. So you're just taking the derivative of a different piece each time as you go through. and multiplying those all together and then just adding up those individual pieces. So this is what the product rule formula will leave you with. And this would be the derivative of our function y with respect to x. So like I said, I'm going to talk later in the week as well about how to apply this product rule when you have the product of three or more functions, and how to apply this same pattern to three functions. And you can, like I said, apply that same pattern to four or five or however many you need. So these are very useful pattern formulas because you can apply them to more and more functions, not just the composite of two functions making up into each other or the product of two functions going into each other. So it really is a useful pattern discussed in that Calculus Lifesaver book. So go check that out. It's a good read. It's very affordable, less than $20 for the ebook and for the paperback version, whichever you prefer. The link is in the description, so I highly recommend checking that out. But hopefully you found this video helpful. If you did, please give it a like, subscribe to my channel. Those are great ways to help support the channel so I can keep making more videos like this. Be sure to come back later in the week for more. Thanks and see you then.